Hey folks, we got for you today a very fast one. Got some more stuff coming, but this is the white tiger metropolitan animal from Pilot 91 141. Although I think the rest of these numbers make more sense. Anyway, a friend of mine has one of these. It was the first little Pilot that I saw, and he loved it. I've got other colors. No, they're all upstairs, but I have other colors of these, and pretty simple. They have instructions for mechanical ballpoint gel and fountain. Neat little box. I always like this concept of it's about as cheap as hell, but it's actually hinged and. I like the way Pilot does this for basically a $10 to $12 pen. It's got a ink reservoir, and it takes the CON 50, CON 50. And I didn't think ahead to make sure I had one for this video. Great. Comes in one of these. This is what the CON 50 looks like. I have like five of them coming. Get them in bulk, because they're cheaper for the shipping. Had more. The bladder fills are what they come with. We'll use one of the bladder fills. I don't mind. I'm going to be pulling a bladder fill out anyway. So this is one of the cartridges. The CON 50 is a regular piston fill. It's a great little pen. It's got tigery stuff. I don't have autofocus on because it just makes for a lot of trouble with this particular setup that I have. It goes back and forth. Nice plastic lining on the cap. No blind cap. It's all one piece. This is a plastic sleeve that is melted down, heat shrunk on all of them. They have different patterns for the different colors. Right? Here's our little bladder fill, which is going to be one is typically fixed, the other one moves. So you can see how we're going to just squeezy, squeezy. And I think in one of my videos, I showed how to do that. This nib is not supposed to come out. I got a fine because I like extra fine, but you find that with Japan, they're like one size over. Let me see if this guy wants to come out. Oh, God, that was easy. No, that was real easy, actually. Why would they say the nibs can't be replaced? Yeah, that thing basically fell out. Now it's going to be small. Here's a number six by comparison. I can't even see this. These are number six nibs. This is the one from the Pilot. All right, so if you zoomed in or something, you'd probably be able to tell. How small. I'm gonna have to find out what size this is because I want to put a replacement nib on this. I can't imagine how great this pen is gonna write with one of Brian Goulet's custom nibs. He has them manufactured with his logo on them. And replacement nibs are where it's at if you want your pen to just be stellar. So it's really easy. It's just a normal feed, just like any other feed. Yeah, they make you think when you're looking up replacement nibs and stuff for these that they're crazy. There's a little notch that's cut in the nib. You won't be able to see this very well, if at all. But there's a tiny little notch right, oops, sorry, right there in the middle of the nib. Just a notch right there. Now you think that's going to line up with something. So you look on the feed assembly where the nib's going to go, and you find no such little nibby, tippy, titty, nipple thing. Nothing. It's just like all the rest. It just sits on there. In fact, nope. There are no There's nothing in here keeping this from spinning the wrong way. And it sits way back. It's hard to describe, but the nib kind of fits in a little bit. It fits. Now, there's a reason for that. There's ribs on this side that only go so far and ribs on the other side that only go so far. So the part where the nib goes is actually a smaller diameter. So if we were going to look at this from the side, from the front, here's the feed assembly that we're looking at. There's a notch cut right here. This is cut out. And the nib itself has this look in profile. And then down, you know. So this part here, because remember we're looking at it from the side, this part here slides into here. So it does kind of lock, and that's interesting. So it's not going to twist back and forth around the feed assembly. See how it fits in here? You can probably, if I get the light to shine just right, you can probably just see it. Again, I'm sort of apologizing for the autofocus, but not really, because trust me, this is even better than if it didn't have autofocus. All right, so the sucker comes apart real easy for cleaning, which is really good. Let's see if it locks into a certain position. Let's spin and see if she wants to go in any one particular position. Nope, it's just a pressure fit. Wow, why do people say that you can't take the nib out of here? Weird. Okay, so the co-star of this video is a new bottle. I've just been dying to use this thing, so I'm just taking a couple seconds. I'm in the middle of work. I'm just going to go ahead and fill this up and go back to work. Oh, we're still using plastic. Eventually, the plastic, I'm told the bottles are now, Nathan has the glass manufacturer straightened out with how they're going to make the bottles and stuff, so we can go back to the real bottles. But for the time being, we have to put up a 3-ounce plastic generic things that just have the regular. Now, the sticker is the same sticker, you know, same deal. It's just plastic. So here we are promoting, you know, using ink, not these cartridges, and, you know, save the world and all that. But all right, so this one is called, oh, and it's on so well. This one's called, I don't even know what it's called, to tell you the truth. I can't figure this one out. It's Squeteague or Squeteague, if you want to say it's like league, Squeteague. All right. Here you go. Squeteague. All right. You guys can tell me how to pronounce that. But I've been looking for a great blue. Anybody who follows me at all knows that I'm always in looking for a blue. This is Pilot's Essigao, the Yuri Suzuki stuff. And I've been looking for a really great blue because blues... Blues have issues, right? Blues are more slippery than normal inks. They, in general, you know, I'm sure there's exceptions, like Quink and all those, but they tend to be really slippery. And what that means is that they go through the assemblies really quickly. And so the normal functioning of the vacuum and the feed and letting just enough go and the balance that occurs in a fine fountain pen, it's kind of thrown off a little bit by the blues because the blue ink just really wants to go out. So I've been looking for a really great blue. I saw this one online, and not like I have a calibrated monitor, okay? But it really looked good in the tests that I saw. You know, a great way to test this is to break out a glass pen where we don't have to worry about the nib and such. Let's take a look at what the ink looked like. before I throw it into this pen, because remember, the pen's going to write a very, very thin line, and it's very difficult sometimes with a, almost all the time with a very thin line to tell how the ink is going to, what kind of character it has, right? So I'll just use a glass pen simply because they're much easier to clean. Squeteague. Squeteague. Whatever it's supposed to be. And I like this one because it has some gray in it. Now, I know your monitor is going to look different than mine and all that. By the way, glass pens rock. I see this is not a blue. Like this Pilot Asagao Morning Glory. This stuff is blue. And it's bright blue. It's almost, you know, I wanted something I could use at work that was professional. I'm still trying to find a way to have dip pens with me when I walk around, you know. A lot of time, you can't really tell how an ink is going to look, or at least compare it, until you're able to see it up against a reference color. So what I'll do, it's just something strange that the light does, both in the camera and in your eye, to fool you into thinking that you had some paper towels and napkin pen. Where are all my rolls of paper towels that I always have around? Now, there's two kinds of cleaners. This stuff, Speedball, which is real liquidy, I don't like it. Guess why? The first time I used it, little bit of ink, boom, tinted the whole thing red. Then there's this stuff, which ends up being really, really good. This is by Kohinoor, K-O-H-I-N-O-O-R. They're like a generic craft place. And this stuff is not like that. I've used this a couple times already, and look at it. The reason is, as we'll see, this is goopy stuff. It's not runny like this is. This is goopy. So when I dip into here, the part that I want clean, nothing comes out into here. But look, all the goop is in here. So I can clean out all my little tines and I don't contaminate any of the ink in the next container. Look at that. How fast is that? And it doesn't contaminate it. Look. So get this stuff. Or somehow put this in another spray bottle. I don't know how the hell you do it. All right. That was this guy. I always clean him as soon as I'm done. Let's take a look. Now that you've seen it, I'm looking for something semi-professional. Let's go ahead and fill this little guy up with the bladder fill, which of course we're not going to continue to use. We're just using it until some Con 50s come in. As I said, they're these guys, Pilot C150. Just be sure to get the ones from Pilot. Don't get the cheapy replacements. I hear horror stories. Okay, in she goes. Let up very gradually with my finger because we don't want cavitation in the air bubbles, right? So I'm going to put back in and take in more. Some people have to do it three times. I don't care because these guys are already on the way. Okay. Sometimes we can tell a lot by how the ink absorbs into a paper towel, and here you can tell it's very clean. Doesn't have multiple colors, multiple consistencies, and I like that. Like a nice consistent ink. The next thing that we do every single time we do our inks, before we forget, is we always mark in the ink log which pen got what ink. It's not always that easy to figure out. So this is today's date, 17. This is, I already like the feel of this, just like the other ones, very consistent. This is the Pilot Metropolitan White, and it has Noodler's Squeteague. Always keep a log of what ink goes where, because I'm telling you, in a pen that's empty or a line, black looks like black, and I've got a whole ton of blacks that are not the same, but they all say black. So, Noodler's Squeteague, and I can already tell these nice thin lines here are very light, grayish blue, nice and dark, where you want it to be. This nib, the Pilot Fine, is just like an extra fine in the US, which makes me very, very happy. All right, there you go. That was weird enough with the distraction. So I'm going to let you go and strongly recommend this for a blue. I think I'm going to take this upstairs and I'm going to do some notes with it and such. You can't go wrong with this Pilot, the MR collection. This has got a pearly kind of a finish to it. It's not a straight up white like this is the Jinhao knockoff of Lamy Safari. It's actually got a crappier white to it, but you can tell the difference. They're not the same consistency. It doesn't feel metallic-y. It's a smooth finish, but it looks metallic-y under. It's a very neat look. And that's it. So, I will, if I can get back into the computer here, I will see you guys next pen.